First off, why was it so important for you to put this concert on tonight?
Well, people paid a lot of money for tickets.
Yeah.
And anytime people pay money for a ticket, and then you find out that a situation happens as it did, and there wasn't going to be any refunds, there was no chance that I wasn't going to make it happen. So I'd have been disappointed just as a performer, let alone as if I were a ticket buyer. And
yeah.
I plan to come. I'm here. We're going to do it. It's going to be great.
Have you run across anything like this before? Like, is this unique to this situation now?
It's, yeah. I have not.
You guys been in the business a long time.
I have been in the business a long time, and it's tough. Yeah. You know, we really don't usually deal in these kind of situations. We've been around this far too long.
Yeah.
But it's okay. We have the ability and experience to still deliver the promise to the person who wants to come and see it.
Right. I guess as an artist, also when you hear people on Twitter and things like that saying, "I can't believe this," and so upset. I mean, you as an artist read that, you think, "These are the people that, you know, pay my salary."
No, I don't think of it like that. I don't work for anybody. I make art, and if people want to buy art, that's their business.
Right.
But what I do care about is that I have a commitment. And dedication and commitment to anything is paramount with me. And my integrity is more important than anything. I don't care about money, and I certainly don't work for anybody.
Right.
No. So I'm here because my word is my bond. You know, so I'm here.
This is going to be a very intimate show with people.
Yeah.
Sort of thinking back to the beginning, right?
It's, you know, well, it's not that small. It's, you know, it's, well, 7,500 instead of 15,000. But
yeah.
Again, that wasn't my doing. Last time we were here, we sold the building out.
For sure, yeah.
I'm not worried about that.
No, not at all. For the fan experience, it's huge.
It's great. It's cool. Plus, this isn't the band,
right?
Remember.
Yeah.
This is my fun band, I call them. You know, this is my summer band. I actually start rehearsing with the band for the tour tomorrow.
Yeah.
But trust me, this is going to be fun. You know, when we heard Robbie Krieger was going to open, like, we're doing Touch Me. He might not be there, but we're doing. And I'll play all the hits, and we're gonna just show you a little more of who I am, what I do, why I do what I do. Mm-hmm. Not only all our songs, but these are the songs I grew up playing, and these are the things I like to do with, you know, my spare time. So tonight's an all-encompassing show. It'll be a unique show and an experience for everybody. It'll be like a block party.
Yeah. Talk about the new music that you have came out yesterday. Describe sort of what this so-called album is.
Yeah, Burning Bridges is the end of an era, really. And it was meant to coincide with a Southeast Asian tour that we were doing. It's a fan record. It's under the radar.
Right.
But it's also the conclusion of a 32-year relationship with my record company. And it was time to move on. The traditional model wasn't working for me anymore. And so it was both a fulfillment and, more importantly, something I'm proud of, because it's songs that, you know, I wouldn't put out otherwise. But the record is almost done, and it comes in the spring.
Yeah. What will we see in the record, the next record? What is it?
I think it's a record of a... boy, there was a lot to get off my chest in the last year. You know, I mean, I went through a lot of turmoil, both on this playing field and on others, and I had a lot to write about, which is wonderful, because a writer looks for things to write about, not just Moon, June, Spoon, and love stories. You know, you got to find something, and I think this one really is about that integrity and that, you know, that kind of taking a punch and getting back up again, or learning to fly, you know. So I hope that people relate to it. But it's in essence done. You know, I mean, I got to tweak things, but I feel great.
Now, you obviously have, you mentioned the turmoil that you're having and things like that. When you go, you know, into a new album and you don't have everyone that you're comfortable with you, that she's not there, do you ever, like, look up and go, oh, it's different now?
Look, the greatest thing I can tell you about my relationship with Richie Sambora, which was fantastic, and still,
yeah, for sure,
as far as I'm concerned, he'll always be my friend. We wrote some great songs. The greatest thing I would tell people about him was, you'd be lucky to call him your friend. Greatest thing I could ever say about anybody, man or woman. And people think that being in a rock band is a life sentence. It's not. You know, it's an art, and when you want to share that art, you do. There was no falling out. There was none of that nonsense in the Google machine that said, you know, money or fighting or whatever. He didn't show up to work one day.
Yeah.
And subsequently didn't show up 82 other times on the tour. I got the message.
Yeah.
But, you know, everybody understands, because it's grueling.
Yeah.
It's a very difficult life, and it's a very difficult life when you're a single parent. You know, there's a lot of things that came into play.
Yeah.
And so I understand, but it doesn't mean that I can't continue to make art, or that Tico and Dave should suffer for it.
Sure.
So we made another record.
Yeah. And you still enjoy the touring and all that? You like the
not to the level that I did when I was a kid. You know, when we came up here 29 years ago to record Slippery When Wet,
yeah,
the idea of living up here for a couple of months was wonderful. It's more fun than you can ever imagine.
I could probably imagine.
I was in a rock band. But the idea of living out of a suitcase to me isn't all that appealing now.
Yeah. This was very different 29 years ago.
There wasn't a lot of the town was much different. Yeah. Sure, our lifestyles were much different, all that kind of good stuff that went with it. You couldn't get here directly. You know, there wasn't even a direct flight to Vancouver back then. We're talking before cell phones, before fax machines. You know,
yeah,
well, I had to walk uphill to school both ways.
Carrying ice.
<Yeah. laughs> So it was a much different era, and it was great.
Yeah.
The city was coming alive at that time, and we were lucky enough to be a part of it.
And the last thing is, what would you say to those people in Vancouver who are going to come see you tonight? What would you want to say to them about everything that's happened?
Amen. You know, I mean, it's been a hell of a ride. It certainly isn't over. I'm sorry what happened this weekend, but as I was able to, and with the help of the tourism board and the arena and you know, our management, and all of those who helped to fix this mess, let's just forget about it. Put it behind us, you know. Like Bill Belichick says, we're off to Cincinnati. You know, I mean, let's just go have a block party tonight and not worry about anything else.
And nothing bad's happened to Belichick afterwards.
He's got four rings to go with. That's another story.
John, thanks very much.
All right, pleasure.